process of elimination for ICD-9. Hello, do you have a Blitz process for elimination of ICD-9 questions? Seems there is a process for this, I hear. Thank you, Leticia. So, as many of you already know, if you've come to one of our webinars before, I really enjoy ICD-9. Laureen's the CPT guru because she actually had to deal with billing more than I've ever had to deal with, and I like diagnoses. I like diseases, and I like the disease process and learning about them. So, this is a fun question for me. Let's go see what I decided to write. Okay. Now, when you sit down to break down ICD-10 questions in an exam, there's a few quick tips I like to tell you. There's keywords that are going to help you navigate acute and chronic, and due to. If you see those words, then you know that that's pertinent to the code that you're going to use. Okay, so those codes should just absolutely jump off the page at you when you're looking at a report. Now, some examples of that. You've got acute pericarditis unspecified, 420.90. Okay, now, what if you had something else? Let's see, 423.8, other specified diseases of the pericardium. Okay, then, which would be like chronic pericarditis. But what if you had acute and chronic pericarditis? Well, look, you would use both codes, 420.90 and 423.8. Okay? Now, let's take another example. Let's say most codes that are acute and chronic, they're going to have their own code to go with that. Okay. Now, when you look up in the index for chronic pericarditis, the index of your manual is going to tell you the code is 423.8, but when you go into the tabular, it's going to say other specified diseases of the pericardium, which means chronic pericarditis is that. Chronic pericarditis will not be listed in the tabular, but it is listed in the index, so you have to trust the index that that's the proper code. Okay, so there's two codes for those two separate conditions, but there are codes that can be acute and chronic at the same time, and respiratory failure is one of those. If you go look up 518.84, it will say acute and chronic respiratory failure. Okay, so see how important it is to know if it's a chronic condition or an acute condition, and if it's acute and chronic. A little tidbit, know that acute codes are listed first if there's two different ones. So if your person has acute and chronic pericarditis, acute will be listed first because that's more severe. It's acute. It happened suddenly, onset. Okay? So also there's some little excludes there I left up there. Now, due to or late effects. Let's look at 438.11, late effect of cerebrovascular disease aphasia. Okay, so what they're saying is your patient came in and they have aphasia. Why do they have aphasia? Because they had CVA. Okay, so that code explains that. 438.11 means your person has aphasia. Why do they have aphasia? Because of a CVA, a previous CVA. All right. So, one code took care of both of those terms. Now, let's look classifications that are only three digits. Now, all of these codes up here, notice that they're 4 and 5 digits because they can be more specific. Thus, we're switching to ICD-10 because we can't be any more specific, but yet our education has increased and the diseases, we know more about them, and so we need more digits. But there are still some codes that only need three digits. And one of those is pneumonia, okay? And you don't know what type of pneumonia it is. It's 486. That explains it all, Okay. Now, unless you just have that memorized, and you're never supposed to just memorize codes, but if you're dealing with codes over and over again, you will memorize them. So when I look at these three codes, I automatically know, because I deal with them daily, that these are three-digit codes that don't need any more classification or description. Pneumonia, if I don't know what type of pneumonia it is, it doesn't tell me if it's viral or bacterial. I know it's 486. You know, that explains it all. Three digits. What about a person that had a past MI, an old MI? It's 412. As long as it's more than 8 weeks old, it's a 412. And I don't need any more explanation on that. Or COPD, it's 496. Three numbers, that's all it takes, and that explains the situation. Okay. Now, there's not very many that are just three digits, but those are three of the most common that I know. And there's more out there, I'm sure. But those are just happen to be the ones I have memorized.
Get more CPC exam tips, coding certification training, and CEU credits. Go to www.codingcertification.org.